my esteemed panelists, Mr. Randeep Bora, Deshpreet Chopra, Srishti, Kiran Patil, Mr. Khare, and Mr. Chauhan. It's my pleasure to be here and moderate the session. What I'm going to suggest is that all of us who make a presentation for, say, 7-8 minutes, and then subsequently we will have a panel discussion. As a part of the presentation, I would be talking about the rooftop solar. Can you just put on the presentation, please? I will give you the background about this particular presentation. My company, that is Idam Infrastructure Advisory, we are working with a USAID-funded project called Partnership to Accelerate Clean Energy Deployment. And as a part of, we are working in 8 states in development or scaling of the rooftop projects. As a part of this particular study, we carried out stakeholder consultation with developers, essentially to understand what challenges they are facing and what could be the solutions for those particular challenges. So what I will do is that I will present a few slides on those challenges and then probably what could be the solutions. So I have already covered this particular part, that is, what is the PSD project and what is the IDAM's role. IDAM is a lead technical consultant for this particular project. So what we have done is that we have identified the challenges in the 4 major areas. And these 4 areas are policy and regulatory framework, interconnection process, implementation related issues, and then the capacity building or media outreach related issues. I think the first two are little important slides. The challenges primarily lie over here. And among this policy and regulatory issues, I think the net metering regulation in the state or at the state level is a really a big challenge. The kind of requirements that it prescribes in terms of the net metering requirements. Among those, the first one is how much of the rooftops is you are allowed to install. Some places it is you are allowed to install 100% of the connected load, some places it is 60%, some places it is 80%. Then there are other requirements in terms of the DT loading. So what percentage of the DT capacity you are allowed to connect this rooftops on the LT side of the DT. So that's the first challenge. It varies from state to state, and also within the state, depending on if the distribution companies are different, sometimes they interpret it differently. So that's, I think, the first challenge. We need to work around this particular issue and have some kind of standard to be set up by CEA. There could be some rules in terms of what could be the, essentially the distribution companies concern should be that, you know, there should not be reverse power flow on the distribution transformer and not anything else. So, you know, keeping that in mind, how exactly the quantum of rooftop to be allowed onto the distribution transformer is something one need to look at. The second issue typically we come across is the chief electrical inspector's approval, but I would cover that issue into the interconnection related issues. The net metering regulation, the second challenge which comes up is a maximum rooftop capacity that can be installed. And this is particularly a challenge for industrial and commercial users. 1 megawatt is the maximum capacity that is permitted. And many a times we have seen the requirement is far more than, or possibility is also far more than 1 megawatt. So that's really a challenge which is coming across in states. Of course, the UP and Odisha, 2 states have taken exception and allowed more than 1 megawatt capacity to be installed on a net metering basis. But the other states, bigger states, particularly Maharashtra, Gujarat, they haven't taken a very, what I would say, they have taken actually very strong view and not allowed anything more than 1 megawatt. It's difficult for the large corporates to work in this kind of environment. There are entities such as, say, Metro Railway. Their requirements are far more than 1 megawatt. Their ability to install is far more than 1 megawatt, and they are not able to do that. Another funny rule which utilities are implementing is they don't allow you to increase your sanction demand. Many a times, you know, the sanction demand has been approved several years back when the first time the connection was taken. And typically, we come across the sanction demand for a household of 0.5 kilowatt. Okay, And now if you want it to be increased because you want to put up a solar rooftop, actually your consumption is far more than that. You have installed large several appliances after that, but you're not allowed to increase the sanctioned load. Coming to the interconnection process, utter confusion. Who should be buying meter? Or who should be doing inspection? At what time? Chief electrical inspector. I think this is the biggest pain point in many states. Some state regulators or in some states the utilities require that electrical inspector should approve the drawings as well as installation, even for the as small installation as 10 kilowatt. If you look at the Government of India's rule, it says if you are installing a DG capacity of up to 500 kilowatt, you don't need approval. But as soon as you move from DG to solar, you need approval even for 10 kilowatt. Okay, it's the same thing, it's connected on the same bus, but still you need an approval for 10 kilowatt, 20 kilowatt. In Maharashtra, it's 100 kilowatt in some installations and 200 kilowatt in some installations. So that's a big challenge as far as the interconnection process is concerned. In terms of the drawing approval at the distribution company level, as well as electrical inspector approvals are concerned, some states electrical inspectors, that approval process has been given to the distribution company, so it's okay. But in some states, it's the two different approvals are required. I think the biggest issue is the time which is taken to implement the entire process. Many a times it takes 3 to 6 months to get all the approvals in place in some of the states. So that's, I think, the huge issue. In terms of interconnection, as well as in terms of net metering regulation, the status of RESCO is also a challenge. In most states, third-party RESCOs are permitted, while the legal interpretation of the RESCO is still a big challenge, because you cannot sell electricity without a license, but the third-party RESCOs are permitted by the regulators within its powers, except for one state, that's the state of Gujarat. Of course, we come across a lot of RESCO projects in Gujarat, and I still don't know how they do it, because RESCOs are clearly not permitted in under the Gujarat net metering regulations. What we really need in terms of the implementation challenges, I have not looked at one particular challenge which I would look at it over here, that is a state nodal agency and its involvement. Every state, the state nodal agency's involvement is important, whether subsidy is required or not. For the rooftop systems, and it's a very, very time consuming process. If you look at the rooftops, haven't penetrated to the residential sector significantly today. I think one of the reason is the apathy at the SNA level, also lack of understanding of issues at the SNA level. Barring the states which are bigger states, at all other remaining states there is a huge challenge on with the SNAs. For the bigger states like Maharashtra or Gujarat or Madhya Pradesh, the challenges are different. They are just that their organizational structure isn't ready to deal with the large number of rooftop projects. So what we really need is some kind of a technology solution which would enable rooftop project developer to key in at one place and get all the approvals through some technology. And as a part of this particular PhD project, we are developing some such solution for Andhra Pradesh DISCOM, a technology solution which would integrate SNAs, electrical inspectorate, distribution company, and even banks for all activities such as inspectorate approval, DISCOM approval, SNA approval, as well as if one wants to make a bank loan. Finally, the last slide of my presentation, I don't want to exceed myself the time. So the last slide, the challenges which are related to the capacity building and media outreach. As Anand said, there is a huge hype about the solar rooftops. And most people can't recognize the difference between the 2.64 number which has been arrived at or which has been bid out for a very, very large scale project with very, very special risk mitigation measures to the solar rooftop project. The challenges which are involved in getting loan for cooperative housing societies or RWS in the country. The kind of issues which are involved into the lease of the rooftops. So, you know, but because of the hype, even that the rooftop sector, we have seen the people demand very, very low numbers. and then it becomes absolutely impossible. So the media outreach is required for if the rooftop sector has to grow at a sustainable rate. There are large number of companies which have come up and actually which are also going bust. I recently came across three companies which in the rooftop sector, we started rooftop EPC business and went bust. So, you know, the large number of players are interested in the business, but unless and until the government takes some concerted efforts to create outreach, to create awareness about the rooftop segment, it's going to be a challenge. As far as the distribution companies, SNAs are concerned or electrical inspectorate are concerned, both. Human resource solutions are required, wherein you train those people to look at the different types of rooftops and the challenges which are involved, and also train the distribution company engineers to really operate in an atmosphere where there are a large number of rooftops which are connected. So the technical training as well as the IT solutions, both are required for the distribution companies as well as SNAs and electrical inspectorate. So these are the challenges that we have seen in the last, in our survey, which we carried out of us around 60 developers across 8 states in last 6 months. I will stop over here and then I will invite other speakers to speak. Thank you.